Hello everybody, my name is Kamal Chaudhary and today we'll learn about the Jarvis repository, which is available at jarvis.nist.gov. More details about this repository in an article format can be found in our NPGA computational materials paper, which is publicly available. And you can see that we talk about the JARVIS-FF, JARVIS-DFT, JARVIS-ML and several derived apps, which is a part of Materials Genome Initiative and funded from the Materials Genome Initiative at NIST. We give a brief overview how does different length and time scale simulation work, such as quantum mechanical, molecular mechanical, so on. And then we talk about several components of JARVIS, which has the idea of materials performance based material design. And we talk about the JARVIS tools and its capability with some examples and different kind of workflow which are used in JARVIS, different kind of databases and number of properties that have been developed, and comparison with experiments and high fidelity data wherever available. And then we talk about several derived apps such as JARVIS heterostructure and 1-year TB, and most important, the accuracy and precision analysis and so on. So let's get back to the original website. So as I showed, there are different components of JARVIS, and there are several websites. So these each are, you can click on them and go to the detail page of density functional theory, force field or molecular dynamics, machine learning, the JARVIS tools on GitHub, JARVIS 1-year tide binding for 1-year 90 kind of application, JARVIS heterostructure, JARVIS current tunneling microscopy, JARVIS Jupyter Notebooks with Google Colab, JARVIS workshops, which are hosted once in a year or so on, the slides and the publications. And it also has some links such as YouTube, Google links and LinkedIn, Twitter and so on. Some of the statistics of the database is available and several contributors is listed here. So let's get back to the website. So first of all, I would like to point out that to access the website, well, most of it, you need the account. So if you go to the jarvis.nist.gov, you'll see the option of sign up option here, and you can sign up here using request account, and then you can put your username, something, whatever your username and password. If you see at, I don't know, gmail.com or edu, or I don't know, whatever your email, and confirm your password here, and it will go to the send request here, and it will go to the admin, and within few seconds, it will be a few minutes, it will be approved. After you log in, you'll be able to access, for example, Jarvis Density Functional Theory, which is a DFT or quantum mechanical method based website. You can go here, and for example, suppose you're looking for bismuth selenide, click bismuth selenide, search, and you can see several options. So we have different IDs, its formula, space group, crystal system, several properties such as topological spillage, bulk shear modulus, Poisson ratio, formation energy, and so on, as a nice chart which helps you just take a glance on material, and then you can click on any one of them. Suppose you are interested in R3 bar M, and you click on them, it goes to the detail page of that particular material. So you can see again the overview of the material properties. You can show the crystal structure in POSCAR format, in conventional cell, in XYZ format or SIF format. You can visualize the crystal structure here. It has several atomic structure based kind of analysis, such as angle distribution function, the dihedral distribution function, and so on. X-ray diffraction using copper alpha, electron density of states, electronic band structure, spin orbit spillage, that is with and without spin orbit band structure, and topological spillage, dielectric function, density functional perturbation theory based dielectric constant, which has both ionic and electronic part, piezoelectric tensor, infrared intensity, Raman intensity, finite difference elastic tensor, phonon at gamma points, electric field gradient, which can be used for NMR kind of application, thermoelectric properties, and we believe that all the key points and cutoffs will be converged for each material, unlike other databases. So we do converge for each material, and which is shown here how it converged. We linked with other databases such as Materials Project and some other links such as ICSD and Aflow and others will be soon available. We also provide the input file output file for each calculation. You can click, for example, any of them, and then you can show, it will show you the it will download the data, input output data, and you can open them to see what kind of files are distributed. You can see the POSCAR, INCAR, which are typical WASP input output files, and you can and plot them analyzing by yourself. Such data is available for all most of the materials and with several calculation types. So this is just for one examples, and we have like 45,000 such materials. If you refresh the page, you can also screen materials based on give me all materials which has, I don't know, a band gap from 1 to 2 and spillage from 0.5 to 1 and so on, and search and you'll find whatever spillage materials are. So several filtering techniques can be used along with that, and you can again find details about that of that materials. So this is JARVIS-DFT. It has also a nice voice recognition feature which can be used for if you voice recognition search. Feel free to try it out, it's pretty fun. Tell me about silicon.
Here are the results for tell me about silicon.
So yeah, it shows you the silicon based structures and so on. So this is a JARVIS-DFT. Let's go back to the original website. We have another called JARVIS-FF. So in this we have different kind of interatomic potentials based calculations. Suppose you are looking for aluminum, so they are like more than 20 or 30 atomic interatomic potential or classical force field. You can click on them, and it is using, for example, aluminum, and you can see their properties calculated using LAMP software here, so such as elastic tensor and phonons and vacancy formation energy and so on. The JARVIS-FF, JARVIS-ML is where use machine learning and classical force field inspired descriptor to predict properties. So you can click on the submit button, and it will show you the machine learning predicted properties of a material for arbitrary material. We in the second app, which is really available, is we can click on similar to the DFT and FF part, and it will show you the machine learning predicted property for around 1.5 million materials. So all the three DFT and FF and ML form the core part of the DFT and is used for both mono elemental or mono element binary and ternary kind of compounds. There are other apps as well, such as Jarvis 1-year tight binding app, which can be used for 1-year tight binding based property prediction. So this, for example, you can select one of the materials, let's use silicon, and you can solve the band structure for arbitrary k points here, and it will show you the band structure solution, which is solving the 1-year tight binding Hamiltonian here, and density of states and so on. So this is a 1-year tight binding model. There are similarly, there are other apps such as scanning tunneling microscopy and heterostructure. In the heterostructure app, you select a particular material and then hit submit button, and it shows you the crystal structure which can be used for DFT calculation or visualizing structure, different kind of band alignment. And the second app can be used for making two different heterostructure. Suppose you have two POSCAR kind of format, and if you want to make a heterostructure, then you can use this and for simulating the crystal structure of the heterostructure, and you can visualize in Vesta or crystal maker or other files. So this is Jarvis heterostructure. There's similarly Jarvis STM, which can be used, for example, making STM positive or negative bias images for hundreds of materials. Click submit, and it will show you the STM images for different materials and different biases and so on. So these are some of the derived apps, and many of them are coming along. Another most important part is the Jarvis Tools, so which is actually a GitHub repository. And you can see this is the website, and we provide the codes with some examples here, and we can install this using pip install Jarvis Tools, or you can follow detailed instruction here. You can see that If you are not familiar with Conda, find more about Conda here, install Conda environment, make a My Jarvis environment and so on, and install the GitHub based Jarvis, or you can just using pip install Jarvis tools and so on. After you install, you can test it whether this whether you can make a simple crystal structure or not, where you can download the 36,000 material data or not, whether you can download 2D material, 1,000 material data or not. So once you are familiar with it, you can find several tutorials here. How to use DFT, how to run DFT calculation, how to post-process the data, how to run similarly the classical force field calculations like using LAMMPS, and how to train machine learning model. So all of them are nicely packaged in one package or one tool, so which is nice. We have also the notebooks which can be used to run the Jupyter notebooks. So if you're new with Python, you can just click on this, and after you click this, you will have a button called open in Colab. Hopefully this will load soon, it might take a few seconds. There are several notebooks and which are continuously being added here. These are Colab notebooks, so unlike Jupyter notebook, you have to install the Jupyter and so on. In the Colab notebook, you don't have to install any software. It will be installed in your Google account, using your Google account, and you can do several kind of analysis and so on using the Google Collaboratory. Alright, so something opened. So let's click on the open in Colab, and it will open the colab.research.google and so on. And you can install, this is a simple hello world kind of thing, just to check if it's working or not. So yeah, and this is a simple Python beginner example. And this is an example, for example, simple silicon crystal structure analysis. So you have to install the Jarvis tool using pip install Jarvis tools, run anyway, and it will install the Jarvis tools on your Google Colab platform. Please remember that anytime you open your Colab, you'll have to install again, because after you log out or turn off your computer, the Colab will delete the folder for Jarvis tool. So anytime you want to run it, you'll have to install from scratch. And there are some example how to make crystal structure and how to visualize data, how to make a machine learning model and so on. And we are adding a lot of new examples there as well. In addition to that, we have several other examples in the test folder, which can be used as another helpful guide for for example, Elastic Tensor, how to test tensor and so on. So these are several examples which are available. The Jarvis tools have different components such as AI, core, analysis and so on. And in between, there are several modules, for example, solar cell efficiency, topological spillage, STM and so on. You can find the documentation on the Jarvis tools notebooks, or you can also find it in the DB docs. So you can find the tools documentation here. And if you want to know about each modules, you can find the read the docs page here, and which will explain you the several modules which are available in Jarvis. So these are the Jarvis tools package. We have the slides, so you can find some of the slides which are shared. This is a good presents a slide on overview of the Jarvis database and so on, so you can take a look, and there are several other presentations available here. And yeah, so this is a overall view of the Jarvis, and if you have any question, please feel free to contact us. You can contact me at kamal.chaudhary@nis.gov, or you can just go to the help button and press the contact button, and feel free to send me an email and we'll be happy to respond. Please let me know if you have any question, and we are looking forward to hearing from you. So far we are hearing some nice comments on our database, and it's very encouraging. So anytime we hear from you, it helps us to, it encourages us to make the database, as well as it helps us to show our managers that we are doing good work and get continuous funding. So please feel free to contact us and with your feedback or questions and so on. Thank you again for watching this video.